Hello, welcome to the MLA Core Elements of a Citation video. My name is Marla Turgeon and I'm your Sandberg librarian. Today I'm going to walk you through the core elements of a citation and I'm going to show you how to create a citation for an article from a Gale database. I'm going to show you the basics, but note that this video will not tell you everything you need to know about citations. There's just too much. You'll need to go to the MLA Handbook, the Library's LibGuide, the Purdue OWL, or ask for help from your instructor or library staff. The 9th edition of MLA was updated in 2021 with a universal set of guidelines to include digital publications. The elements in the chart are listed in the order they should appear in your citation, and each element in your citation is followed by the punctuation shown. Some elements are optional, depending on the source you're citing. I'll point some of those out in the following examples. Let's start with the author. The name is usually around the top of the article. In this case, and with most all Gale databases, the information you'll need is at the top of the page. The author is Joanne Margaret Hines Dusel. Now, I can't just copy the name right over. MLA requires the author's name to be inverted. So it will be written as Hines Dusel, comma, Joanne Margaret. And since there is only one author, we add a period to indicate that this part's done. When you have more than one author, use the word and between their names and list the second author in common form as shown in the example with two authors. When you have three or more authors, invert the first author's name, then use et al, which means and others. The al is always followed with a period when used in the citation or when using it in an in-text citation. This is where things can get tricky with exceptions in MLA. Author refers to the person or group responsible for the work. If the author is an editor, then follow the name with a label that describes the role and put the name in the author element. Corporate authors, institutions, associations, government agencies, or other kinds of organizations can be used as authors. Be aware that if the work is published by an organization that also authored it, then list them as the publisher. Now, if there is no author, editor, or corporate author, then skip the author element and begin your citation with the title of the work. The article's title comes next. This will be at the top of the document also. There are two things you should know about article titles. The first thing is when you copy them into a citation, you format them by MLA rules. Sometimes you could run across a title that's printed in all caps or all lowercase letters. But MLA requires it to be in title case. Title case is the technical term for capitalizing the first letters of the important words. The second thing you should know about article titles is that the title should be encased in quotation marks. In MLA, quotation marks indicate small works enclosed inside of a larger work. And this is an article that's held inside of a journal. If you're citing a book, then the title would be italicized since the book is a whole unto itself. In other words, if the source is self-contained, then the title is italicized, and if the source is held inside something, then quotation marks are required. Next, we close the title with a period which goes inside the final quote. Your citation so far should look like this. Hines Dusel, comma, Joanne Margaret, period, quotation mark, practice and motor learning, period, quotation mark. After the article information comes the journal title. This is where the article lives, or is what MLA calls the container. In this case, the container is a journal called the Physical Educator. Journals get their titles in italics because they're larger works. Remember that a container can also be a book. It could be a book that's a collection of essays, stories, or poems. So if you were citing a poem from a book, the title of the poem would be in quotation marks, and the title of the book would be italicized. Now let's get back to the citation at hand. There's no period after this title because journals don't just have titles in this section, so use a comma here. You might have other people that have contributed to the work you're citing besides the author. If it's important to your project or to help identify the source, then this is where you would enter the name with a description of the role, such as translated by, edited by, directed by, narrated by, and introduction by. Generally, you'll find additional contributors for books or media, not for journal articles. If the source is a version of a work released in more than one form, then identify the version in your citation. Books are usually issued in versions called editions. If no edition is mentioned, you can assume that it's a first edition. In that case, don't use this element. So let's get back to the article citation. There are other things journals have: volumes and issues and dates. Volumes have multiple issues, just like TV shows have multiple episodes within a season. Volumes are like seasons, and their issues are like episodes. This article is from Volume 59, Issue 2. We noted in the citation as lowercase VOL period 59 comma, lowercase NO period 2 comma. And in case you didn't notice, that NO stands for the issue number. Now, dates can be a little trickier. The article might just give you the year, it may give you a month and a year, or it could give you the season and the year. Whatever it supplies, the rule is to include as much of the information date as the source is giving you. In this case, we can see that the issue was published in spring 2002, so that's what we include. Now, something new for the 9th edition of MLA is a publication date rule, which states that seasons should be in lowercase. Notice how we're still working within this section, so we're using commas throughout. When a section is complete, that's where the period goes. The exception here, of course, is after those abbreviations. So you may have noticed that I skipped the publisher. In the case of articles and periodicals, you're not required to include the publisher. This includes all periodicals, that's journals, magazines, and newspapers. Now, if you're citing a book, remember to include the publisher before the publication date. Okay, so we're back to the article citation, and this is how it looks at this point. I have the author, title of the source, the title of the container, the volume and issue numbers, and the publication date. Make sure you use a comma after the publication date. Now, at the end of the citation, we still need to indicate the location, and in this case, it will be the database that the article came from. I found this one in Gale Academic OneFile. The database is also a container, so the name should be in italics. Also note that OneFile is one word. That's its actual brand name, so we leave it as is. Put a comma after the database name. Now, if you have a physical copy of a periodical, this is where you would put the page numbers. You would use a P period for a single page and PP period for multiple paging. Or if you're citing a book with poems, essays, or stories, you will need to use those page numbers. If you found an article online such as this one, you need to add the URL. Look for a link called permalink, stable link, or get link on the article page. These are links that won't change. Don't use that URL link you have in your browser. It won't work for your instructor later on. Some articles may have what is called a digital object identifier, or DOI. If one is present, use it instead of the permalink or URL. Now, add a period at the end of the section. The date of access is not required, but it is necessary if the source doesn't provide a date of when it was published or produced. If you're using something from the web that doesn't come from one of the library's databases, I highly suggest you use the date of access. So here it is. This is what your citation will look like. But there's more. MLA citations require a hanging indent. That means that the first line of each citation starts at the left margin, and subsequent lines are indented. Now, don't just use the tab key for this. The spacing will be off. Instead, give it a hanging indent using your word processing software. Don't forget to double space too, and your works cited list needs to be in alphabetical order. If you don't know how to do those things, feel free to ask for help. Since I talked about anthologies, I want you to see what a citation for a short story from a book will look like too. The author field includes the person Charles Brower, who wrote supplementary materials included in the book. The title of the story is in quotation marks because it's contained within the book. And the title of the book is italicized since it's the container. Remember, if there's not a container present, then there's no need for quotation marks. The title would be italicized. The other contributor is included. Cynthia Johnson is the editor. Simon & Schuster Paperback's edition is the version element. And there's not a number element for this citation. Remember, that's for periodicals with their volumes and issue numbers. Simon & Schuster paperbacks is the publisher element, and the year of publication is found in the publication date element. And the pages the story can be found on ends the citation as the location element. I know it seems repetitive to have Simon & Schuster listed in both the version element and the publication element, but having both of those elements lets the reader know that the work has been released in more than one form, and it will assist with locating the version you used. So, of course, I'm a librarian, so I have a works cited page. But while I'm here, I'd also like to point out that there are different styles of citation in the world of academic writing. I only shared information about MLA style in this video. Make sure you're using the citation style your instructor is requiring. You can find the information in your syllabus or in the paper's directions. If not there, then ask your instructor. Well, this is the end of the video. Thank you for watching, and please feel free to reach out to me for any assistance you might need.